We try to understand what we have to focus on when talking on education, and we thought of what are the main problems of today. And we know that we're in a globalized world where interconnections between cultures, people, societies, countries are becoming wider day by day, and our society, our reality is changing day by day in a very fast way. And as Nelson Mandela said, education is the most powerful weapon we can use to change the world. And this is why higher education should really try to understand how to change itself in order to give students the right tools to face all of these problems we are going to talk about. So we know that, or we think that, three are the main pillars of education, and which are knowledge, competency, and values. And when talking about knowledge, we know that the first thing that we have really to understand is that globalization is a complex process. It doesn't have only bad aspects, it also has good ones, and we have to recognize them, and we have also understand how to deal with the problems that comes with this process. And we also know that we should know more maybe about human history and philosophy, and we know what the main universal human values are, even if we are divided into societies, countries, cultures, nations. And we have to understand, or better, higher education should teach us the preeminence of democracy, the preeminence of human rights, and also the importance of social justice. And we should understand that we should prefer equity over equality, but I will talk about that later. And we're talking about competency. What are the main, or what can be the main competencies that we have to develop in order to face the problems of our world? We think that critical thinking is something that universities should work on. We, as students, should not only be taught notions, which are good, obviously, but we should understand how to analyze complex problems from different points of view at the same time. And we thought that multidisciplinarity is a really good approach. Talking from my own experience as a political science student, I learned lots of things from different disciplines, and this is what multidisciplinarity is about, but every discipline remains within its boundaries. And this is why we talked about transdisciplinarity, which is a more holistic approach, where every discipline kind of transcends its boundaries. And through transdisciplinarity, maybe we would be more able to see a complex problem from different points of view at the same time. And this could really boost, in my opinion, our critical thinking, the way we think and see the world in a critical way. And it is also important to learn, for our students, to learn to speak in front of an audience and to debate. And talking from my own experience, I really have to thank my professor Oliviero Fattorillo, who's not here, unfortunately, with us today, because he tried to make us get out of our comfort zone. He kind of forced us to speak in front of an audience, and I was like really worried about it, but then I decided that I had to challenge myself. I did it. It was quite it was a cool experience, you know? And this is why I'm here today. So this is really important, because if it was possible to do that, I wouldn't be here today. And then we talk about the ability of dealing with conflict. When talking about human relations, conflicts are a daily problem. So universities should teach us how to try to avoid them. And when this is not possible, we should understand how to solve them in a positive way. And talking about, for example, international relations, we must understand that war prevention is one of the most important thing in our world. We must understand that war leads to nothing but death and destruction. So we need to understand how to avoid conflicts. And this can be teamwork in activities is, I think, a good way to deal with conflicts. While working on a team, in the recent days, we shared our ideas. We had some conflicts also, and we were able to avoid them, and here we are today. And we also talked about intercultural competency in communication. And talking always from my personal experience, I think that anthropology is such a great subject. It should be taught everywhere, I think. Last year, Denise and I attended an anthropology course with Professor Michela Fusaschi, that I will never stop thanking, because after this anthropology course, like our minds blew up, okay? And now we are able to see the world in a completely different way, and we are able to understand other culture. We learned about cultural relativism, fundamentally, which is very important in order to create strong relations between countries. And also intercultural workshops are a very good tool, like today and yesterday. We are sharing our ideas with our friends coming not only from Korea. And it's amazing that we kind of know that what the real values of humanity are, even if we come from different cultures. And also, obviously, student exchange programs should be extended. Like in Europe, you have the Erasmus program, and it would be amazing if universities from really all over the world could create more connections. It would be amazing to go to study to Korea, and it would be amazing to have many Korean students coming here to study in Italy. It would be great. And it is also important for university to make sure that professors, researchers coming from different parts of the world come to the universities in order to make students learn from researchers, from professionals who have a different approach to teaching. And then we talked about the competency and about the adaptability, leadership, about the communication skills, how to deal with the media. And I never knew of the existence of the MOOC, I don't know how to pronounce that. I like, those are the online courses, and you can like pay $9 and you can attend an Harvard course online. And I never knew about that, and it would be really great if universities shared more about this kind of information. So I knew about that from my friend and colleague Denise. And also stages, it is important for universities to create good connections with companies in order to make students to learn how to deal with the world of the job. And thanks. Okay, yeah. and I try to go as fast as possible. Talking about values, universities should teach students about the importance of self-esteem feelings. Like, we have to understand that failure is the worst kind of failure is actually not trying. If we try and fail, we will have the chance to learn from our mistakes. If we try and actually succeed, we will boost our self-esteem and we will be able to be really to achieve in a better way our goals in life. Then we talked about the importance of social responsibility, and it is important to prefer equity to equality. And then we have to talk, we talked about the environment. It is important to understand that we, at the end of the day, we are all humans besides the cultures and countries. And we live on this planet, it's the only one we have, and the way we treat it, on the way we treat it, depends how our existence as our species. That's it. Thank you for listening.